Baby, like say you got the formula. The way you wind up my body make me shiver. Sure you no mind if I call you for my cellular.
Hi everyone, what's up? What's good? Okay, I'm joking. And welcome back to my channel. And today, just by the title down there, just so that's what we're doing today, because I don't even know what to call this. But yeah, I'm just gonna like do my makeup. Don't come at me. I don't do step by step makeup, and I'm not really that good at so don't come for me. And yeah, let's get into this. And I'm gonna be like talking about uni update, because I'm not in uni, I'm at home, I'm in London now. So just like, I was gonna do a uni, but yeah, but I'm doing it now anyway. So uni update,
but I wonder if they hear anything is me.
Oh yeah, and sorry about the noise, because someone just bit. Okay. Ooh. Okay. So my sister is just, this little friend of mine. Can you know me? Oh my. Anywho, if you see me talking to someone or whatever, it's my sister, and the noise is coming from her, so I'm sorry about that. So yeah, let's get into this. So obviously I start my eyebrow. So, firstly, I hope you guys are doing fine, y'all doing good, and so, uni updates. Obviously, when I went to uni, I went on the 4th of October, which was on a Sunday, and then we got emailed that our class is gonna start the following day. So I had to like arrange my room, I had to like clean my room, like disinfect everywhere literally, and then slept. So woke up at 9:50 for class, literally 9:50. I just woke up, turned my laptop on, and I was just staring at the laptop like, okay, here we go. And then yeah, that was how my uni started. And one thing, obviously, you know, when is your first day going to uni, you're excited about freshers week. Well, because of corona, innit, we couldn't have no freshers week. I mean, we did, but we didn't in a way. There was no motive, there was no nothing going on. And mind you, I'm at South End campus, so there's really like all them them clubs or whatever, it's not in South End. So if you're going to Essex University, I'll advise you not to choose South End, but that's my own opinion again. So if you like it, just come. So yeah, and I was like, okay, I mean, I can meet people, get to know people, I mean, go to people's flat. And the next thing we hear is, oh, you're not allowed to go into people's flat, you're in a bubble. And there's 6 people in my flat, and we're all first years, we're all doing nursing. I just thought, we want to like get to know people, get to meet people. And I was like, oh, you're in a bubble, you don't need to, you're not allowed to go to other people's flat or house. And I was thinking, what was the point of the antibodies test we did then? Because we did antibodies tests to know if you have corona, and like, especially for people that are coming from like, maybe as an exchange student from another country or like some places other than Europe. So yeah. My first experience going to uni wasn't what I was like. Jesus Christ, English Ligonja. Expecting, that's it. Because someone shall have this on here. So it wasn't what I was expecting. So I was like, what's corona got to do us like that? But what can I do? So, but one thing that my flat did is, so basically, we're not allowed to bring people into our flat, but we did. And people bought drinks, playing games. And you know what's the funny thing? Security comes to your flat every 30 minutes. To make sure that you don't bring other people from other houses to your flat. Oh, something funny happened. So obviously we did that, they caught us, I'm not gonna lie, and then everyone went downstairs to smoke. Obviously I don't smoke, so I did go downstairs, but I was just like chilling with them, getting fresh air and stuff. And then next thing you're hearing is, one day we did the same thing, and then we heard like someone was downstairs checking if security was coming. And then once they see security, they just text us, and then we had to like tell people to go to our rooms. Some people went to my room. Can you believe that? I was the one downstairs with some other girl from our flat, so we were the one checking for security. We just said, let's go downstairs for fresh air. went downstairs and we saw security going up our flat, like literally straight to our flat. It's like someone snitched on us. So we went, we called the other girls, like, oh, security are coming. And they all went to my room. Some of them went to other people's room just to say that the security goes, because security finds them, we might ask them for their ID and maybe like give them some kind of final warning. So now, cool. Like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, they were still there. I was like, rah, this security are not coming out, you know. So me and the girl, we went upstairs. So we're going upstairs. I went upstairs first, and then I saw one of the security men standing in front of the lift. I was like, rah, okay. I went in. I saw one in the kitchen was just standing there, like. And funny thing, all the drinks and everything was on the table. No one packed it. No one took it. Like no one moved them. And I was like, rah, okay. So I was just talking to the man. I was like, oh, hello, how you doing? He was like, hi. And then I started packing the bottles. So I started putting some of them in the cupboard or whatever. And the man was like, oh, I was like moving as if I was cleaning up. And the man was like, oh, so now they're making you do all this. Now they're giving you work to do. I was like, no, it's fine. I mean, this is my flat, so I chose to clean it. And I was like, okay, then. I was like, right. So I went downstairs. So I texted them, the people in my room, I was texting them, like, you guys don't come out, you know, the security is still there. I went downstairs with the other girl. And before we know it, me and the girl went back upstairs again. And the next thing, security was knocking on our room door. And one of the girls in my flat was like literally hyperventilating. She's like panicking, and then she had to come out. And the security was, that's how security, you know, you get, definitely there's some people in the room, isn't it? And the security went in the room. And then the guy said, some of the guys in my room, they were like, oh, there's someone, they were in the bathroom, and then the security tried to open it, and then they were trying to like pull it, like close it, and obviously the security knew they were in there. Tell them to come out, and just so funny. And then they all came out. I'm not gonna lie, we still kept doing that thing again, like kept inviting people to our flat, because I'm sorry, this quarantine is hard at all on people already. And then we're in uni, you know, young people now, they always want to socialize and get to know people and go out and stuff, but we can't go out. So you're telling us, even in this whole accommodation, no one can see each other, no one can go to each other's flat. Like, that's absurd. Like, you're gonna have to, I don't know what you're gonna have to do. All these 30 minutes coming to our flat safe, I don't think it's gonna work, to be honest. And yeah, that happened. So we didn't have no freshers week in a nutshell. And we tried to like make ourselves, you know, to do stuff for us, but we couldn't. Even the society or whatever it is that I think they have, I don't think they do. There's not nothing going on, man. It was so boring. That one's literally in their room. You know how people do, some people just drink, no motive, no nothing. They just say, you know what, dress up, make up and everything, sit down, start drinking, playing game by themselves. Okay, that happened. That actually happened. And you know one thing that annoys me about uni, every single Saturday, like every Saturday at 12 on the dot, the fire alarm goes off. Tell me, are we in the prison? Like, if you want to do fire drill or fire whatever drill, at least maybe every two Saturdays a month. But literally every Saturday, and it goes on for like almost an hour. So every 5 minutes it's like continuous, and then it stops and starts again for an hour till one. And I'm just laying there on my bed, like, and they sent us an email telling us, oh, you have to come out before your alarm goes off. Excuse me, I'm trying to sleep and you're even disturbing my beauty sleep. Like, no, leave me alone. So I just stay in my bed, like, just laying there, like, till it stops. And then once it stops, try to sleep again. But god, it's so hard going back to sleep because I can literally hear the sound in my ears.
What I cannot do, tell me what I cannot do. ni o ta lenu o po lenu o tu lenu tamo ta kano tu tamo ta kano tu. Excuse me, you are not dancing. Why? I want to know why you are doing like a shy. Is it that you dance or you leave? There's no place for pretense. I can't watch you stand. Oh no. Oniko cho cho cho, oniko bere mole cho. I know you want to know, I sweet it to amu. Oniko cho cho cho, baby no dolly no. I know you want to know, I sweet it to amu. Ni o ta lenu o po lenu o tu lenu. Tamu ta kano tu, tamu ta kano tu. Oni o ta lenu o po lenu o tu lenu. Tamu ta kano.
Pull up in the drop, cause I'm not you. Sure there's no be master. Cause I look up and I let the fire drop. No say they go down, y'all, but if you go.
Oh my god, let me tell you guys something that happened here. So obviously there was this girl, such a lovely girl, Alexander. She's a first year as well, but she's doing business. I met her at the uni, but she's in like in another house. And this girl, she said she wanted to do photo shoot, and then I said cool, I'll take the pictures for you. And this girl, she said, oh, she wants to do it in the car park. I said, nice, cool, I'm gonna do it for you. Got ready, went to a flat to go to the car park together. And then we went on the lift, and then I went downstairs, like, to the ground floor. And then she was like, let's go. Always, she said, through the fire exit. And I thought, have you ever been down here before? She said, yeah. You went through this door? Yeah. I said, cool, okay. Immediately she pushed the door to open, the alarm just went off. And then guess who came? The popo. The police came, and then this girl was standing. The police was literally standing in front of the car park. So we went, ran upstairs, like, I was panicking, I'm not gonna lie. She was like, Fermi, calm down. I was like, rah, this girl, you're bravo. And then I went. Oh, this is the wrong one. Oops. This is the wrong brush. There we go. And then this girl, we went up the stairs, ran to her room, like to calm down. And then she was like, let's go back. I said, where? Me, I'm scared though. She's like, come on, Femi. Me, I'm scared though. Femi. I went with her. So we went outside the building to go around and into the car park. And the police were just standing there. I was like, this girl, you're brave. Well, the police are here because of us. People, the security was coming out. This girl was posing though. Posing, taking picture. I was like, rah, this girl's brave. That day was funny. Like, the alarm was literally going off for like an hour. Literally an hour. Police were standing there. Security came out. Security was standing. Poor guy. Elderly person as well. Just standing there. Was even telling us, oh, how you girls doing? How are you? And in my head, I'm thinking, oh my gosh, we're so sorry we brought you out. It wasn't, we didn't mean to. This girl, she's brave. She's so lovely as well. But yeah. What else do I want to tell you guys? What's wrong with my accommodation?
Do you like it? It looks nice. Have you seen other people?
I don't.
You don't like your accommodation?
My accommodation? My accommodation? I don't like it. It's like a prison. It's like a prison. Like, you know them room in prison. I'm not gonna lie. Literally, the bathroom floor and the toilet floor is literally leveled. Like, there's no gap. Like, I don't know how. Like, you see, I'm gonna do a room tour. I haven't done a room tour because I really hate the accommodation, but now I have to do it to show you guys. Like, I hate it, I'm not gonna lie, I hate it. And my room, literally, I'm literally facing the smoking area, and then when people smoke, I can actually smell it. Like, sometimes I smoke weed. Yeah, I can smell it, and I'm like, oh my gosh, when is this gonna stop? What is this gonna stop? I really like the, like, my, where my room is. The only thing I like about it is the lighting. When the sun is out, oh my god, my pictures be looking bomb. You know what I mean? It be looking bomb. So that's the only thing I like about my room. And the fact that the heater works 24/7, like, you can turn it on, you can control it yourself, actually. That's one thing I like as well. But the rest, psh, don't like it. And the fact that, to be honest, one other thing I like is the six of us in my flat, and we have two fridge, cooker, everything, two, everyone has a drawer. And the same thing that we have two of, some people, there's like 11 of them in that flat, and they have to share it, and they have two of that thing as well in their kitchen, which is, for me, I think that's what I like about, yeah, I just like that about my flat, because it's just six of us. So, and the girls in my flat are so lovely. Everyone like helps each other out, we use each other's stuff. Obviously, make sure you wash it when you use my stuff. Yeah. But apart from that, everyone's lovely. Like, lovely in my flat, very lovely. Also, you know, when you order stuff here, obviously, you have to put the university address. Your package is actually safe to the fact that they literally ask for your ID, the one with your picture on it, your student ID, before they give you your package. And that one of the girls, she gave another girl in my flat I did to literally help her get her package. And the security was like, nope, let the girl come herself. Come get her package. And I was like, wow, so the package is safe then. Just something, it's just good. But I'm like, I'm literally being patient, like, okay, let's wait till next year. Maybe I'll meet new people, to be honest. Because if I don't meet people, I'm gonna be pissed actually. And if there's freshers week next year, this definitely is gonna be like for the next year coming. Ah! Oops. What's I gonna do next? Right. I was actually gonna do this next, this one. But then again, I wanna talk about like the fact that, so if you guys can hear anything, my sister, she's on a online course, so excuse the noise, I'm sorry. So one thing that I actually wanna talk about is the effects of this magic thing happening again on my mental health. One second.
My baby, my Valentine. Can I do make you a temperature today? If you leave me a good time, I swear. You are like the oxygen I need to survive. I'll be honest. Loving the daughter in me, I am so obsessed. I want to chop your heart. Never did it back any feel. Open up, make us feel. Give me love, one thing, thing. Me make a bad man.
For your head, talk all they want. I don't care what they say, cause your matter. Now, in my con, they carry for my head every night. Now, you are one, they carry to my bed. Oh, no, no, don't tell me, no, no, no. You can be my partner, never ride this. Oh, no, no, I ain't got no one lucky. No, no.
So, the thing is, like, this thing on my mental health was kind of like, kind of like made me, there was a point that I was kind of like withdrawing, to be honest. Like, I didn't want to go out. I was literally in my room. I only come out when I want to eat, or if I need to clean my room, then I get the hoover and I put it back and I go back to my room, literally. And the next day, my sleep pattern was messed up. It's not that I'm going out to do anything though. I'll just be in my room, I'm awake. I'm on the phone, like, I didn't really go out, do stuff or anything. Which I didn't know. And then at some point, I was like, you know what? And then that was when I started my faith journey, which I'm not really gonna go into that much, but I said my faith journey, I thought, hey, hold on. It made me think actually, like, about how this year has been for me. And funny enough, even during all the pandemic and everything that was going on, this year was the best that's ever happened to me. Like, the stuff that happened this year was the best thing that's ever happened to me compared to past years since I've been in this country. So made me think, and I'm like, oh, God is good. Like, I'm really grateful to God. Like, and I didn't even, and then God is not asking me for anything, like, but I'm just sitting here. Like, he didn't ask me for it, well, anything or whatever, and he's doing all this thing for me, which kind of made me start my faith journey. And I'm really happy because when I started, the stuff that's been happening, it's crazy, like crazy mad. But if not for God, then if not for God, I don't know what I'll be saying right now. I don't think I'll be saying what I'm saying right now. All I'm gonna say is spiritual warfare is real. That's it. The end. It's real. 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 To be honest. There's actually one episode that happened. One of, like, first time the teachers, my teachers were using Zoom in it. The session was for an hour. Can you believe this teacher spent 30 minutes to figure out how to use the Zoom, how to share a screen? I was like, rah. Really? And then while on the session, the next thing I was hearing this woman tell us is that one of the teachers was like, oh, she's got a bounce because it was past four. We needed to finish at four. It was past four and she was like, she's got a bounce. She's got to pick a child from school. And the next thing, the person that was talking was like, oh, I don't mind waiting for another 15 minutes. I said, what? You and who? Yeah, I left straight away. About another 15 minutes. What are you talking about? Who wants to stay another 15 minutes with you? That was so funny. And I actually had stuff to do that day, so couldn't really say.
Stare. lẹ́nu. Tamo ta kana du. Tamo ta kana du. Oni o ta lẹ́nu o ko lẹ́nu o du lẹ́nu. Tamo ta kana du. Tamo ta kana du. Oni o ta lẹ́nu o ko lẹ́nu o du lẹ́nu. Tamo ta kana du. Tamo ta kana du. Oni o ta lẹ́nu o ko lẹ́nu o du lẹ́nu. Tamo ta kana du. Excuse me, you are not dancing. Why? I want to know why you are doing like you're shy. Is it that you dance or you leave? There's no place for pretense. I can't watch you stand. Oh no. Oniko cho cho cho. Oniko bere mole cho. I know you want to know. I sweet it to amu. Oniko cho cho cho. Baby, no doubt.
Stress, you go down on top. Then go the talk, go talk, go talk. But then they love you, love you, love you. Money you ta lenu, pa lenu, o tu lenu. Tell me what I cannot do. If you need the money, I go connect you. And if you go wrong, I go correct you. Cause if you fall down, I go forget you. Nobody go come to your rescue. And we could just stay for my life.
Money you ta lenu, pa lenu, o tu lenu. Tell me what I cannot do. What I cannot do. Only your talent, who call and who do lend. Come what I cannot do. Come what I can.
Kiskis on the beat.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
She said, don't talk, but you let's make magic. Oh, yeah. If you leave now, baby, it'll be tragic. I know you a virgin, now you ain't tried this. But she said, pop a little pill and let's fly, baby, let's make magic. Because memories don't live like people do. Then
thank you guys for watching and listening. I didn't even talk that much, but thank you guys, and I'm gonna show you my outfit. See you later. Thank you guys for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And yeah, I mean, you just seen another side of me right now, so thank you guys, bye.
Commander-in-chief, baby, just surrender. I'ma put you at ease.